I do not need a ride home. I'm not at the airport. I'm in Sevilla.
What? You know, I can't hear you. I can't. You're breaking up. Okay. You know. Imagination, you're fine, right? Nothing bad has happened, nothing bad's going to happen, right?
Thank you. dos o tres horas para arreglar este elevador.
No, 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 I understood that much. 2 or 3 hours? No, I cannot be in here that long. I don't think you understand. I mean, I have plans. I mean, very special plans and plans I don't plan on breaking. So you need to get me out of here now. Comprende?
No.
Now.
No te apures, señorita. Ya mismo sale de aquí. Tengo que trabajar ahora, pero ya mismo regreso para ver cómo está.
Oh, please. You have to get me out of here. Now. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I'm usually not this angry, I promise. It's just, I mean, of course this would happen to me now. I mean, course of all times. I mean, I have a date. I mean, I have a very special date. I met him today at the bullfighter. It was a stroke of luck, really, because, I mean, everyone kept saying what a wonderful experience the bullfight was, and to go and see it, and really, it was just the opposite. I mean, it was just this sick, sadistic ritual to abuse this powerful animal, and I couldn't take it anymore. You know, I just couldn't handle it, and I leave, and as I go through a door that I think is the exit, or maybe a bathroom, I came face to face with one of the matadors. And then I remember thinking, is it over? Then I saw it. The huge beast was only a few feet away to my right. His nose was aflame, and he was bloody from where he'd been stabbed on one side, and he looked at me as if for help. And then I realized I was wearing red. Well, I guess I passed out, because when I came to, there was the most beautiful man trying to wake me up. Swept me off my feet. Literally, I mean, I guess he was standing behind me when I passed out and he caught me right before I hit the ground. Wow. Won't that be a cute story to tell the grandkids? Hello? Hello? I mean, I thought that this assignment was supposed to help me, right? I mean, give me a little bit of downtime, get out of the country, dance a little, right? Get a break, go away, escape the past, spend some time alone, right? I needed the time alone, right? I mean, I was really starting to lose it. I mean, I was a complete basket case, right? I mean, I couldn't go an hour without tearing up. I needed the time alone. Alone with nothing but your purse. Nothing but your purse, because while you're on a first class ticket to Sevilla, your luggage decided to take a separate journey to Canada. Well, you know, it was a nice excuse for a new wardrobe. My mom always says a new dress can help a girl find a new man, right?
turned out rather nice.
The lying and the hiding, and
you had less time for me, and you were acting funny. And you were acting funny. You stopped touching me, and you stopped complimenting me, and I started biting my nails like I was 10, and I started smoking. I mean, I was needy and insanely jealous, but. I went to the airport to pick up my sister, and it was like I had radar or binoculars or something, because you were the first thing I saw when I walked up to the terminal. You and her. You look so damn happy. She was an airline stewardess. Oh, excuse me, flight attendant. And she had perfectly manicured hands and long legs like a friggin' giraffe. Eyes with a touch of silver. My chest caved in. I felt all this pressure inside, like some maintenance crew was weed whacking every vital organ. I mean, I wanted to just crawl in a hole and hide, but I couldn't even move. I mean, I was paralyzed. Then I thought of Melissa, and I knew I didn't have much time, and I didn't want her to see me this way. I mean, I didn't want her to see me such a pitiful mess. I didn't want to hear her criticizing words of comfort or the sadness she would have for her little sister's heart, so I started walking, just hard walking right to you. I didn't know what I was going to say. I mean, for once, I didn't rehearse our conversation in my mind. I just pounded my way to you, to her tall, blonde ponytail and your lucky Armani suit with my favorite tie. When I got there, I just... Astrid, this is Sandy. I'm in love with her. I've been wanting to tell you about it for some time now, but you've been so damn busy with work, I haven't had a chance. Had a chance? I mean, any time would have been better than this. And then you said, do you think it could be packed up by Friday? No, though, I really wasn't paying attention because I was distracted by her luggage tag and her last name. And when you stopped moving your lips, all I could say was, you're leaving me for a stewardess named Sandy Surface? It all felt like a big joke. So I just turned around and laughed.
Scuba diving in the moonlight. When I was out of town, he'd walk my dog and leave little love notes like under the pillows and under the placemats, under the floor mats, and in the dryer. He was a wonderful romantic. He would email me beautiful words of inspiration like, "You are the nectar in my flower, giving juice to my orange."
Hot poetry, the guy was hot.
No, he was not hot. He was charming. He was charming. That should have been my clue. He was charming. I mean, most men are not charming. They may be delightful or irresistible, but they are not charming. Only gay men are charming. God, I should have known. I mean, especially after I came home after that story, during the story of the Chicago Fair, and there you were in front of my full-length mirror, stunningly dressed in my long red evening gown with a fake fur wrap. I mean, God. And when I saw you, I recognize you. Who is this beautiful woman and what is she doing in my house? You look better than me in that dress. Rule number one, never date anyone prettier than you. Oh, but then there was Charles. Charles. Ah, he is older than me. Distinguished, like dating my grandfather. And then there is Billy, who's younger than me. So much younger that I could have been arrested. Michael and everything about me was in sync. We looked good together. Really good together. But if it looks too good to be true, then it probably is, right, Mom? How did I do it? I fell in
so fast, it's like a lightning flash. So in love in just a moment.
Find other interests.
Badminton. Airline stewardesses. What do I get? I get the beloved flannel t-shirt or old pictures as a consolation prize, right?
You leave and I'm left right where I started, right?
Oh, except for this time my only friend is a self-help book. And I'm left alone with plenty of time to read. Roadmap to disaster. When you start a love affair, it is beautiful.
It is.
But it isn't love. It starts as lust. I mean, there it is. That big wow. That G. That yes, yes, yes you've been waiting for. I mean, this is where you find somebody and you think that they are better or cuter or wiser or more wonderful than anything you have ever, ever known. And you think, I have no need for food. I have no need for sleep. I have no needs. Other than occasionally chewing a breath mint. You are probably the best thing that's ever happened to me. That's probably because you haven't happened to me yet. Then you move on to euphoria. You feel funny inside. And you feel funny outside. And you feel you could do anything and no one would dare laugh at you. I mean, this love you will treasure. You will not throw it in the basement with that old twister game and that rowing machine you used once. No, you will not take this love for granted. And then you think, I feel so good. I feel so strong. I feel actually attractive, and I can learn to live with that feeling. Oh, let us sing, and let us dance, and let us eat brown mushy foods low in fat. Oh, joy. Oh, but what if I'm no good at this? I am no good at this. I'm a dingy speck on the wall of humanity, and look at how badly painted that wall is. This is when fear sets in and doubt clouds your mind, and this is when you fear what you need most, and you think, what if this stinks? I mean, what if I'm wrong? What if my heart has blinders on? I mean, it's had blinders on before. I mean, how can anybody love me if I don't love myself? I mean, I love myself. There are just parts between the top of my head and the bottom of my feet that could use some improvement. And I'm not demeaning myself because I have relatives who do that. Then I'm disgust sinks in. You have the strange desire to just hide in your room and eat everything inside and watch old Facts of Life reruns. I mean, now comes the time when you will ask anybody who will listen. I mean, what the hell am I doing anyway? This is love. This is what they tell you about when you're 11 and naive, or 20-something and even more naive. And this is also where you realize you've given up every individual aspect of yourself for it. This love. You're no longer me, but we. Thank you.
Then the end, it's all sound cues. At the end, Jen, that part when I say,
it's the opening.
Yeah, you're good.
It's after, I don't think you said it.
Yeah. And I say,
hold on, I
last page. Great, being left.